I knew Victor Lorenzo.
Yeah, I knew Victor.
Yeah, I know Victor Lorenzo. That son of a bitch. I got two words for you about him.
Nice.
Prodigy cheeks.
I know Victor Lorenzo.
Lies. I cried, she was deaf. And she worked on my face until breaking my.
Is it on this time that there's an article published in Young Art next monthly? That publication. But Victor had a way that, even though it seemed like things were going good, he still had to go on the wild side. And it's about this time that we decided to go down to Mexico for a summer. And the big thing there at that time was iguana go-kart racing.
So Victor adopted this pigeon and they went everywhere. They traveled around Spain together, but then one day Victor got really angry and they traveled down to Morocco and he told his grandson pigeon that they were going to see like the best view he'd ever seen, and he took him there and he chopped off his head and threw him into the water.
It's really simple. You just take the iguana, put on its helmet, give it some courses, how to drive a go kart and stuff, and send it on its way. Now, Victor didn't really have any money at this time, and I had a little cash, so we invested in an iguana named Henry. He went undefeated for a whole season until the circuit got shut down by the police.
Victor Lorenzo was one of those smooth-talking kind of guys. He'd talk his way into anything. Back in college, his models weren't even that good, but he could just talk about it. He'd do this kind of thing, he'd do it. He'd reach for the sky when he's talking about his models. So, come back closer. So, he'd do his hand motions and they'd get everybody involved. And so, one of these days, like, just recently, but I haven't seen him in a while, but it was kind of recent. He was telling me about, JT, you should try to eat this stuff called cottage cheese. You should try to eat it. It's funny because the way he told it, it brought humor to the subject, but it was really serious. My little nephew Frankie was by me after the dear old Frankie Lloyd Wright. Anyways, so I had my nephew next to me. Victor's like, JT, you should try to eat 4 quarts of cottage cheese. And I was like, Victor, I don't think that's such a good idea. But Frankie was there and was like, yeah, Uncle JT, I think you should really try to do that. And Victor's like, yeah, JT, you should try to eat 4 quarts of cottage cheese. So I was like, okay, Frankie, Uncle JT's out to prove something to you, little buddy. So I start eating, and I'm eating, and let's just say, it got to be too much to handle, and so I had a point to prove to my little nephew, but I couldn't hold the cottage cheese, and so it just started spewing out, and I tried to eat it, but it kept coming back out. Victor would tell the story way better than I ever would. But Frankie, I think I fried that poor son of a bitch. He just started running. And he took Victor Lorenzo to be his new uncle. But I'm just left here in the dust. So yeah, Victor Lorenzo, I know that son of a bitch. He's got my nephew's Franklin, and I want him back. Years ago, we studied together at Yale. It was a good time. He was kind of an outcast, though. It took a long time. He didn't really open up to people. His designs were incredible. I remember one time, we were walking along the French Riviera, and he said, "I can make that with my feet."
This is the kind of style Victor used to have, you know? Like, this is the simple movement up and down of volume, but this is the kind of, like, radical stuff he would do. It's about taking the simplistic and making it complex. Like, I remember once we were at a party, and it just wasn't doing good. People were drinking and whatnot, having okay time, but we needed some music. And Victor gets one kid his car, like, speakers and whatnot, and starts blasting that some song, but that song wasn't that good, and he takes another CD with a radio, and he just starts playing with the volume, and he starts having the other kid play with it, and I was like, I have to get in this, because that kid that he told, Victor told to get it, wasn't doing a good job, and you know me with this, because I'm on beatbox sometimes, so I had the beat, and I had the rhythm, and it was like, it was pretty much like Victor was orchestrating the whole thing. And that's the kind of kid he was. Like, we'd be at someone's house we don't even know, just having a good time, and he'll just make omelets for everybody. He'd just look through the refrigerator and just start grilling up some omelet. And everybody's loving it. Because the kid could grill up a good omelet too, but it's just certain stuff people don't tend to do at strangers' houses, and this is kind of little mementos people remember about people, you know?
And at that time, that's when Victor just up and disappeared. I haven't seen him since. I had to sell Henry to the circus.
The single lifesaver on the boat, and he jumped in after him. He tried to save him, but he couldn't. But it's okay, because he saved the 30 rest of us. And I don't know how he did it, but there was 30 of us on one life preserver. And he swam us across that Grand Canal in the shining light of glory, up to by Sam Moose of Bispo or whatever it was. We were all safe. Orphans, so to speak, without our professor. But we made it back all right. I have Victor Lorenzo to thank for that. Steve, Victor, wherever you are.